Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to discuss chapter 3 of class 9th, that is coordinate geometry. This is an introductory video of chapter 3 in which we are going to discuss the basic concepts of the coordinate geometry. So the name of the chapter is coordinate geometry. Actually, coordinate geometry is the branch of the mathematics in which we locate the position of any object which lies in a two-dimensional plane. Any object which is lying in a two-dimensional plane, we locate its position by using the two perpendicular axes or lines, you can see here. Okay, two perpendicular lines. And the system used for locating the position of any point in a two-dimensional plane is known as the Cartesian system. So we can say Cartesian system also or coordinate geometry. Okay, so now let's start how we are going to locate and what are the things in this coordinate geometry or the Cartesian system. So I have told that we locate the position with the help of the two lines, and these two lines are mutually perpendicular to each other. Mutually perpendicular means perpendicular to each other, like this. If I am taking this line as a horizontal and this one as vertical, then these both are perpendicular to each other. This one is also making 90 degree and the horizontal one is also making 90 degree with the vertical one. So I am just going to take the two number lines. Suppose if I take one number line horizontally, number line we denote like this, xx dash. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, that is the positive numbers are here. And here negative numbers. Okay, this is one line. And if I take the another line which is vertically, suppose if I take a vertical line like this, which I denote with y and y dash. So here it will be something 0. And if I am keeping this positive numbers above, that is 1, 2 and 3. This is minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Negative numbers are below, positive numbers are above. So these two lines are there. So if I place these two lines such as these two are perpendicular to each other, that is mutually perpendicular, and they will intersect at the zero of each other. That is, I will place the zero of this vertical one with the zero of this horizontal one. Then how it is going to be formed? Let us see. So first I am drawing the horizontal one like this. This is x and this is x dash. And this is 0 of this horizontal line. And I am taking the vertical line such that the vertical line is passing through this 0 only. And the 0 of this vertical also lies over this only. So this is y and this is y dash. And we denote this intersecting point of these two lines by O. Which letter? We denote this by O. Because this is the 0 of horizontal one and 0 of the vertical one. Here it is the positive numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Here this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and so on. On the vertical axis, the above, there is a positive numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, and below there is negative, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. Okay, so we have the two lines, that is x, x dash, and second one is vertical, that is y, y dash. Now this horizontal line x, o, x dash, okay, this horizontal line x, o, x dash is known as the x axis. What is this? This is known as the x axis. This is the x axis. And this vertical line, that is y, o, y dash, y, o, y dash is known as the y axis. This is the x axis and this is the y axis, and they are intersecting at point, that is the zero, and this point is known as the origin. What is this? This point is known as the origin, denoted by O. Now see OX, here it is what? Positive numbers. So OX is known as the positive direction of X axis, and OX dash, here it is negative numbers, so this is known as the negative direction of X axis, and OY, which contains positive number, so this is also positive direction of X axis. and OY dash, this is negative direction of x axis. So what is OX? OX is positive direction of x axis. And what is OX dash? That is negative direction of x axis. And OY? OY is positive direction of y axis. And OY dash is negative direction of y axis. Okay, so OX is positive, OX dash negative, OY is positive and below it is negative. Now see here, there are one axis, we are saying axis. So if we talk about the two axis, then its plural will be axis. Okay, so sometimes I can say that these two are the axis of this Cartesian system. Okay, now see, these two axes are dividing this whole plane. If this is a two dimensional plane, so dividing this whole plane into four parts, 1, 2, 3 and this 4, you know, 1, 2, 3 and this 4. So these four parts are known as quadrants. What is this? This is known as quadrants. Okay, so these two axes divide the two dimensional plane into four parts. And these, each part, this part, this also, and this also, and this is known as the quadrant. And we number them also. So this quadrant, in which there is a positive direction of x axis and positive direction of y axis, we take it as first quadrant. This is what? First quadrant. Now we'll move anti-clockwise, like this. Okay? Like we'll move anti-clockwise. So if this is first, now we'll talk, this one will be what? Second quadrant. In which there is a negative direction of x axis and positive direction of y axis. So this is second quadrant. First, second and below. Negative direction of x axis and negative direction of y axis. So this one is third quadrant. And this one is fourth quadrant. Okay. First, second, third and fourth quadrant. Just put this one where there is a both positive direction of x axis first and then go with the anti-clockwise. Second, third and fourth. Hope you all have understood this much. This is just a Cartesian system, or we can say coordinate system. Okay. And this axis, for this axis we tell them coordinate axis. X and y axis is there, but this axis is known as the coordinate axis. What is this? This is coordinate axis. This x axis and y axis is also known as coordinate axis. Okay, and this whole plane is known as either xy plane, you can say either xy plane, or Cartesian plane, you can say Cartesian plane also, or coordinate plane, either of these three. Okay, this whole plane with this number lines which are placed mutually perpendicular to each other, this whole is known as either xy plane, Cartesian plane or coordinate plane. And these axes are known as the coordinate axis. This horizontal one is x axis, which contains this side positive and this side negative. Vertical one is y axis, above positive and below negative. And the point where these two axes intersect, this point is known as origin, denoted by O. This axis divide the whole plane into four parts and the each part is known as quadrants. Okay, now this one is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and this is fourth quadrant. Okay, hope you all have understood this much. Okay, now just note it down by pausing the video and we'll continue further. Okay, so now we'll discuss the coordinates of a point or how to locate a point in this Cartesian system or coordinate system. Suppose I'm taking one point, this, and I want to locate its position. Okay, so we locate its position by its coordinates. So what do you mean by coordinates? What is coordinate? Actually, the coordinates of any point is its perpendicular distance from x axis and y axis. What are the coordinates? Coordinates of this point are perpendicular distance from x axis and y axis. So if there are two axes, there will be two coordinates. Okay, so there will be two coordinates. One is x coordinate and another one is y coordinate. Let's discuss one by one. First we'll discuss x coordinate. What is x coordinate? Now the x coordinate, which is also known as the abscissa. What is this? Abscissa. Okay, so x coordinate is also known as the abscissa. Now if we wanted to know the x coordinate of this point, so we should find the perpendicular distance of this point from y axis. If we have to find the x coordinate, so we'll find the perpendicular distance of this point from y axis. Suppose if I draw perpendicular from y axis to this point, this perpendicular, and suppose this is of x unit. So this x is the x coordinate of this point, okay, which is also known as abscissa. So x coordinate is also known as abscissa, which is a perpendicular distance of any point from the y axis. Next one is y coordinate. Which is also known as ordinate. What is this? Also known as ordinate. X axis, abscissa. Y coordinate is also known as ordinate. So for the x coordinate, we have find the perpendicular distance from y axis. For the y coordinate, we find the perpendicular distance of this point from x axis. Perpendicular distance. And suppose this is of y unit. Okay, so this y is the y coordinate of this point. This y is known as the y coordinate of this point. Okay, and also known as ordinate. X coordinate is also known as abscissa, and this is ordinate. X coordinate, y coordinate, abscissa, ordinate. What is x coordinate? X coordinate is the perpendicular distance of point from y axis. And what is y coordinate? It is the perpendicular distance from x axis. Okay. And the collection of these two coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate, is known as the coordinates of a point. Okay. If we take together these two coordinates, we get the coordinate of a point and will represent it like x, y, like an ordered pair. Ordered pair means that first it comes the x coordinate, and second it will come y coordinate in a bracket and there is a comma. Okay, so when we take together x coordinate and y coordinate, we get the coordinates of a point. What we get? We get the coordinates of a point. Okay, now this x, which is x coordinate, that is a perpendicular distance from y, is also known as what? Abscissa. This is abscissa of the point P. Okay, this is abscissa. And this y is known as the ordinate, that is y coordinate. Okay, and this pair makes the coordinate of a point P. Okay, now suppose if I take any point on the x axis, okay, if I take any point on the x axis, suppose I am taking this point Q over the x axis. Now see here, if we have to find the, for the x coordinate, what we do? We find the perpendicular distance. So we will get the perpendicular distance, no? We will get the perpendicular distance, this. So we get the x1. I have denoted as x1. But for the y coordinate, for y coordinate is the perpendicular distance from the x axis. But it is over the x axis only. So it's the perpendicular distance from x axis is 0. So this one will be what? 0. This one is 0. So on the x axis, the coordinates of any point is in the form of x comma 0. What is x comma 0? Okay, and similarly on the y axis, if I take any point T, okay, now here the x coordinate is what? The perpendicular distance from y axis, which will be 0 because it is on the y axis only. So y, and second one is y coordinate, perpendicular distance from x axis, that we can find because here it is x axis and we can find the perpendicular distance. So 0 comma y. So a point on the y axis, either on the positive direction or in the negative direction, the point is on the form of 0 comma y. the first term, abscissa is 0 and ordinate will be there. But on the x axis, the point is abscissa will be there, ordinate is 0. Now see here, this 0, origin. If we talk about the origin, then the distance of this point from x and y axis is 0, 0. So its coordinate will be what? 0, 0. The coordinate of the origin is 0, 0. So its abscissa is what is the abscissa of origin? Abscissa of origin is 0. And ordinate of the origin is 0. So abscissa and ordinate both are 0. Okay. So if I take any point here also, suppose I am taking a point R, and if I want to know its coordinate, what I will do? The x coordinate means perpendicular distance from y axis. I will draw like this and will measure. Suppose this is x. And for the y coordinate, what it will do? Will draw perpendicular this one. Suppose this is y. So the point coordinates will be x, y. Okay. Hope you all have understood what is the coordinates of a point. There are two coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate, and the collection of these taken together is known as a coordinate of a point. X coordinate is what? X coordinate is the perpendicular distance of that point from y axis. And y coordinate is what? Perpendicular distance from x axis from that point. X coordinate is also known as abscissa, and y coordinate is also known as ordinate. And if we take together the x and the y coordinate and written it like as a ordered pair, means first x coordinate and y coordinate, then this is known as the coordinates of a point P. This whole is known as the coordinates of a point P. But if it asks what is the abscissa, so we'll write abscissa of point P will be what? X. And if I talk ordinate, this is what? Ordinate of point P. So this will be what? This one will be y. Okay. What is the abscissa of origin? Okay. What is the abscissa of origin? 0. Abscissa of origin is 0 and ordinate is 0. Okay. Hopefully you all have understood what is the coordinates of a point. So just draw it roughly in your notebook by pausing the video so that we can discuss further. Here I am going to discuss some notes of this, the important points of the coordinates of a point which we have already discussed. The first one is, if there are two points, suppose there is a point P and there is a point Q, okay? And we are saying that this P is equal to Q. What it is? P is equal to Q. These points P and Q are equal. The coordinates of these two points are equal, okay? That is, if P, coordinates of P is x1 and y1, and coordinates of Q is x2, y2. If like this, okay, that the coordinates of the two points are equal, then this implies the abscissa of both of these are equal. Means x1 is equal to x2 and ordinate are equal to each other and y1 is equal to y2. Okay, and similarly, if the abscissa of two points and ordinates of two points are equal, that means the coordinates of these two points are also equal. Vice versa. If the coordinates of two points are equal, then the abscissa and ordinates are equal. And if the abscissa and ordinates are equal, then the coordinates of the points are equal. Second thing, if the coordinates of a point is x, y, okay, if P has a coordinate x, y, then x, y is not equal to y, x. These two things are different. Okay. Here it means x is the x coordinate. Y is the y coordinate. But here if y is coming at the first position, so y is the x coordinate and here x is the y coordinate. This will be equal if, okay, this will be equal x, y is equal to y, x if x is equal to y. That means x and y, both of these are equal. Then only we can see. Okay. Now let's do some questions over this, the coordinates of the point that till which we have studied. Okay. This much only. We'll discuss some questions first. So I have taken one question. The question is, let A 3, 4 and B minus 2, 5 be two points and the coordinates are given. Okay, the coordinates of A is 3, 4 and the coordinates of B is -2, 5. Okay. So now, just what will be the abscissa? What will be the abscissa of A? If we see, so the first abscissa is what? X coordinate, and X coordinate comes first. So what is the abscissa of A? That is 3. Now, what is the abscissa of B? So the x coordinate, the first one, that is -2. And if I talk, what is the ordinate of A? Ordinate of A, that is 4. That is the y coordinate, the second one. And ordinate of B, that is 5. This one. This is the ordinate of B. Now suppose in question it is asking, find the value of abscissa of A minus abscissa of B. Okay, so we have to find the value of this abscissa of A minus abscissa of B. So what is the abscissa of A? 3. Then minus. Then what is the abscissa of B? That is -2. So what will be the answer? 5. Easy? No. So these types of question, easy questions comes just to find what is the coordinates, what are abscissa, ordinate, their difference, or like this. Okay. Now we'll discuss the sign conventions. First, we'll discuss the sign conventions and then how to read the points. Okay, so our next topic is sign conventions of coordinates in different coordinates. Actually, on axis, there are positive direction also and negative direction also. So, there will be sign conventions. Means some will be positive and some will be negative. And in each quadrant, there will be different sign convention. Now, there are 4 quadrants. This one is what? First quadrant. This one is first quadrant. What is this? This is second quadrant. This one is third quadrant. This one is fourth quadrant. Okay. First, second, third and fourth. We'll move anti-clockwise like this. Okay. Now see in the first quadrant. Now suppose if I take any point P, okay, so the distance, perpendicular distance like this, if I measure the x coordinate and y coordinate, so if I measure this, so now the OX and OY both are what? They are greater than 0. If I take this x and this is y, the perpendicular distance from y, this one, this, because the, this is the positive direction of x axis, so x is also greater than 0 and y is also greater than 0, no? Because they both have positive direction. So, what will be x? X is also positive and y is also positive. So, what is the sign convention? The coordinates of the point will be like positive, positive. The first one, x coordinate is also positive and the y coordinate is also positive. Now, see in the second. Here, the OX axis. Now, this x axis, no? Consider this. This one. The x axis, in x axis there is a negative direction, OX axis. Here it is negative numbers, no? So if I take any point and if I have to measure that perpendicular distance, that is the x coordinate here. So it will come in what? Negative. Okay? We are doing what? It is negative. Because the thing is actually the logic is when we measure the distance, we measure the distance from the origin. Okay, we measure like this to the right side or to the above. So if we measure the distance from origin to the right side or the above, it will be positive. And in the opposite direction, like this, it will be negative. Below also it will be negative. So if this is a point Q and if I have to measure this distance, we have to move what? We have to move opposite direction. So here x will be less than 0. But to measure the y coordinate, no? To measure this distance, we'll move the upwards, so that will be y will be greater than 0. Okay, so in this quadrant, the x coordinate is negative and the y coordinate is positive. What it is? X coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive. Similarly, come here. Now, suppose there is a point R. So, if I have to measure its x coordinate, means perpendicular distance from y, this one. So, we will move backward. That is, the x will be what? Negative. Less than 0. Similarly, the y coordinate, that is the perpendicular distance from x axis, to measure it from the origin will move downwards. So y is also less than 0. Okay, because if downward means this is the negative direction and this is also the negative direction. This is positive and this is positive. So in this third quadrant, both the x coordinates and the y coordinates are negative, negative. Now come to the fourth quadrant. Similarly for this, if I take any point like t I am taking to find its x coordinate, this. Now x coordinate is moving in positive direction. No? So x is greater than 0. And for the y, if I say, will move downwards. That is the negative direction. So y is less than 0. So in fourth quadrant, the x will be positive and y will be negative. So this is the sign convention that in this first quadrant, both x and y are positive. In second quadrant, both x is negative and y is positive. And in third quadrant, both x and y are negative. And in fourth quadrant, the x1 is positive and y coordinate is negative. So this is the sign convention. Along to this is the positive direction Ox and Oy, and Ox dash and Oy dash is negative direction. Okay, so this is the sign convention. So just pause the video and note it down, because after this we are going to do questions on all the topics which we have studied till now. On all that. Okay. So just pause the video and note it down. Okay. So the question is, in which quadrants or axis each of the following points lie? Okay. So the question is saying there are different points are given, coordinates of a points are given, and we have to tell that in which quadrants or axis these points are lying. Because I have told you that the some points might lie on quadrants like this and some points might lie on the axis also like this here also. Okay. So we have to check that the which of the following points lies on which quadrants and on which axis. Now see the first one, minus 3 and minus 5. Okay. Actually for this you have just to remember the sign convention. I just tell you, just remember the sign convention. If I draw a small Cartesian system, the two axes, this is x, x dash, y, y dash, this is first, this is second, this is third and this is fourth. So in first, what was the sign convention? Plus plus, both coordinates will be positive. In second, x1 will be negative and y1 will be positive. In third, both will be negative, negative. And in the last one, x will be positive and y will be negative. These are the sign convention. We just have to see that. And what are the points on the x-axis? On the x-axis, it is this type of x, 0. Okay? If it is on the positive direction. But if it is on the negative direction, then x will be what? Minus and y coordinate will be 0. Simple. This side will be minus x and this is x. Now, if the point is on the y-axis or on the positive direction, so it will be 0 comma y. And if it is downward negative direction, so it will be 0 comma minus y like this. So we just have to remember this to answer this type of questions. Now minus 3 comma 5. X is negative, y is positive. No one is 0, no? So not on the axis. So both are the numbers. So in quadrant, first is negative and this is positive. So which quadrant? This is second quadrant. Okay, now see here, x quadrant is positive, y is negative. In which? The fourth one, positive, negative, positive, negative. So this is fourth quadrant. Now see the third one. In this, the ordinate, y coordinate is 0 and there is only x. So x comma 0 type. So in which axis? This is on the x axis. And on which direction? Positive, because the x is positive. So we'll write on x axis, positive direction. Direction that is Ox. No? Ox. This is the positive direction. Now 0 comma minus 3. Here the x coordinate is 0. So if x coordinate is 0 and there is only y, so this will lie on what? Y axis. Now see, y is negative. So it will be downward. No, on the y axis, negative direction. So on y axis, this is negative direction, that is O Y
dash. Now see this, 2 and 2 both are positive. So this point will lie here in first quadrant. So this is first quadrant. Now minus 3 and minus 6 both are negative. Both are negative in which quadrant? Third. So this one will be what? In third quadrant. Hope you all have understood this question, and this is very easy. First, just see the sign conventions and you'll be able to do these type of question. Now we'll discuss next question. Okay, so I have written one questions. In these type of questions, the Cartesian system along with some points are given. Okay, so there's a Cartesian system is given. This is x dash, this is x, this is y, and this is y dash, and some points are given, p, q, r and s. So in these type of questions, so sometimes whether it is given to find the coordinates of any point or abscissa of any point, ordinate of any point, or in which quadrant or axis they are lying. So these types of questions comes. Okay, I'm taking one more point. Suppose I'm taking the another point here. This is T. Okay, so I have here taken about 5 points. 5 points. And for one point, I will write all the things, and for rest of the points, you will do in your copy, on your own. Okay, so let's see for the points P. Which point? For the point P, I'm taking for point P. So first thing it is asking, write down the abscissa of P. So first of all, we'll find out the x coordinate and the y coordinate. So if we have to find the x coordinate means the perpendicular distance from P to y axis, like this. So this is the perpendicular distance. So how we are going to measure this? We are going to measure this by seeing this one. If we see this, the same thing, if I draw perpendicular distance below also, okay. So this one, it is framing what? It is framing a rectangle type, okay. This is, so this, suppose this point is A and this point is P. So this PA is equal to BO, okay. And BO is how? 2 units. BO is how? 2 units. So this one is also what? 2 units, because this is 2. Similarly, for the Y coordinates, we have to know this perpendicular distance, this one. So, now this PB is equal to what? AO. So, this AO is what? 3 units. 1, 2, 3. So, it is coming here 3. So, this will be what? 3 units. So, if I have to write the coordinates, so this will be something 2, 3. What will be this? This is 2, 3. So, for finding out the x coordinate and y coordinate, first draw the perpendicular distance and just see from the opposite side of the axis. I have drawn this, and on the opposite side I can see that it is 2 units, 1 and 2, and these scaling should be equal. It is not like this should be smaller and other should be bigger one, not like that. All should be equal. So there is 2, 3. Now it is for the first, so it is asking abscissa. So for the point P, what is the abscissa? Abscissa is the x coordinate, that is 2. Now what is the second one? Ordinate. What is the ordinate of this point? That is the y coordinate, which is 3. Now the third thing, coordinates. If it is asked for the coordinates, then we have to write like in an ordered pair. That is P, 2, 3. This is the coordinates. Now the fourth, it is asking in which quadrant it is lying. Obviously, this is the first quadrant. So it is lying in the first quadrant. Okay. So for all other points, you have to do the similar. Okay, I just do one favor. I'm just writing the coordinates how you are going to find out. Suppose like this R. So first draw perpendicular distance to x axis and to y axis. Okay, so now see, if you have to find this one, what is this? This is the x coordinate, because perpendicular distance from y. So we can see this is 3. So this one is 3, and this y coordinate, which is also what? Minus 3, because it is lower. So the coordinates will be what? 3, minus 3. Don't forget the sign convention, because we are taking it here. Okay, so this is 3 and this is minus 3. And the easy way, actually the easy way is just draw the perpendicular distance. So if I draw the perpendicular distance on the x axis, the point at which it is intersecting, that is the x coordinate. And on the y axis, the point it is intersecting is the y coordinate. Simple. Similarly, for the Q1, if I draw the perpendicular distance to y-axis and to x-axis. See, now on x-axis it is intersecting at minus 3. The x-coordinate is minus 3. And on y-axis it is intersecting at minus 2. So, this is minus 2. Now, for the S1, I am drawing perpendicular distance on x-axis and perpendicular distance on y-axis. On x-axis it is intersecting at minus 4. So, the x-coordinate is minus 4. Y-axis it is intersecting at which point? 5. So, this trick is also easy. Just see on which axis it is intersecting at what point. Okay. So, it is on x-axis it is minus 4. So, the coordinate is minus 4. On y-axis it is intersecting at 5. So, its y-coordinate is 5. This trick works very. Okay. So, this one. Now, see this T point. This is on the x-axis. So, obviously the y-coordinate will be 0. And it is at point minus 2. So, this is minus 2 comma 0. Now, for all those points, you have to write abscissa, ordinate, coordinates and quadrant. And hope you all will do this. Okay. So, now we'll do the next question. First, for this, just pause the video and note it down this. So, our next topic is that the plotting of a points in a Cartesian plane. We have read the Cartesian system. We have described all other things. We have read the coordinates of a point, how to locate that point. But if you are given a point and how to locate them in a Cartesian, how to plot them in a Cartesian system. The next thing we are going to do, and with the help of this question. Okay. So, suppose this is x-axis. This is y-axis. And by equal distance, I am taking the points. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Above it is positive. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, like this. So, we will continue do with the first one, that is minus 3 and minus 3. Okay. So, first of all, just take a pen on the origin. Okay. Now, see the x coordinate. What is x coordinate? X is on the x axis. So, we'll move either towards the right or towards the left. Okay. Right or left. Actually, if this is the y axis, so this is above the x axis, this is below the x axis. And this is left, right of the y-axis, and this is the left of the y-axis. So, on the right, this is positive. On the left, negative. Above, positive. Below, negative. So, the first is minus the x-coordinate. X-coordinate, obviously on x only. Okay, so what we are going to do, we'll see the sign. It is positive or negative. It is negative. So, we'll move towards the left side, opposite side. Okay, this one. And how many unit? 3 unit. Minus is showing only the direction where you have to move. So, we will move towards 3. 1, 2 and 3. Here we have come. Now, next is what? Next is also minus 3. That is the y coordinate. No? Now, minus it is showing we have to show above or below. So, if it is minus, below. If it is positive, above. So, it is minus. So, we go below. And how many units? 3 units. So, we will see just here. This is 1, then 2. And 3. 3 is coming something here. So, this is the point. Okay. So, this is your what? This is your, suppose I am dealing with P, minus 3 and minus 3. This is the logic which you have to do. But the simpler way, it is given what? 3 and 4. Okay. 3 is positive. So, just go for this. This 3. Okay. And just draw one perpendicular from this. And another one is what? 4. Y coordinate is 4, positive. So, this is 4. So, we will draw the perpendicular this. And where they will intersect this point. Suppose I am representing Q. So, this is 3, 4. Like this. Now, this is minus 7, 6. So, I will extend this one also. This is minus 6 and minus 7. So, here it is minus 7. Oh, sorry. I should extend this one. X axis. This is minus 6. Minus 7 and this is x dash. Now, this is minus 7. Okay. So, minus 7 on the x axis. Here it is. Okay. And 6. So, we have come to minus 7. Now, 6. 6 is positive. So, we will go upward. Here. This one. So if you see, so this is the point. If I draw perpendicular lines also, so we'll get this. So this point, suppose R is -7, 6. In this way, you have to plot the points in a Cartesian plane. You have to take a proper scale, that is this one. This should be equal. And I hope you all have understood all the things which I have discussed in this video. I have covered almost all the topics of this chapter in this video. Okay, so just go once or twice or thrice for better understanding. Okay, and for further question, we'll discuss it in the class. Okay, then thank you everyone and have a good day.